Over the centuries, historical artifacts and writings show that many civilizations specifically trained dogs to participate in wars. From the ancient worlds, Greeks, Romans, Celts all routinely used dogs as guards, messengers, first aid dogs, patrol dogs, mine dogs, and draft dogs to pull carts for food and supplies, including weapons and ammunition. Attila the Hun, who used large Milesian dogs, also implemented these practices, while in the 12th century, Irishmen took wolfhounds into battle. From the 15th to the 18th century, mastiffs were a popular choice on the battlefields from England to Spain and France. In 1884, Germany established the first military training school for dogs, and by the start of World War I, all factions had serving military canines. The most suitable breeds for war conditions proved to be Alsatians, Belgian Shepherds, Airedale Terriers, Schnauzers, Doberman Pinschers, Boxers, and Labrador Retrievers. During World War II, Stalin took the training of war dogs one step further and, using Alsatian dogs, produced anti-tank dog units. Taking advantage of Pavlovian training methods, trainers starved the dogs for several days and then left food for them under a stationary tank. As they formed an association, the dogs soon learnt to run under enemy tanks searching for food. There, they would release an explosive device on a timer strapped to their back, and then run back to their handlers. In practice, under simulated battlefield conditions, the dogs performed poorly. Distracted by noise, they often became confused and returned to their handlers with the dummy bombs still strapped to their backs. Under actual battle conditions, if a dog returned with a real bomb on a timer, the dogs could blow up their own handlers.